All right, what's up, everyone? It's Austin and Cam here from AppSheet Training. We're coming, we are live here at AppSheet Training, Crew Technologies, and we are excited to talk about the App Suite that we've got prepared for you guys today. So I'll let Cam kind of introduce himself, and then if you guys want to hop into chat and tell us where you're from, we're excited to be here with you. And tell us a little bit about what you're looking forward to with our App Suite today. And Cam, what are you looking forward to for our App Suite today?
Yeah, so today we're working on the app launcher for this App Suite that we've been building for this manufacturing industry. And so we're super excited to show you guys how to do that and show you some easy ways that you can do that using by specifying different things within the AppSheet editor to make that process a lot easier, as well as using security filters to either allow specific people to see an app or not allow them to see a specific app. And so super excited for that, but yeah.
Nice. Yeah, I was really excited when I was building this this app launcher, kind of connecting all the apps that we built throughout this month together. It was really fun to just see how quick and easy it was just to open up a blank Google Sheets, Google Sheet, and then add like, I think we added like four or five columns. And then you just connect it to AppSheet, and AppSheet pretty much does all the heavy lifting for you if you set up the Google Sheet doc, right? So we'll take a look at that today. It was really fun making it. It probably took me at most probably about 5 minutes once I set up the database and everything. So super quick and easy to set up, at least the initial behaviors and everything. But then adding some more customizations is what we'll talk about today and how we can make it even more advanced. Sweet. So looks like we got some people joining. Why don't you guys go ahead and join the chat and let us know where you're from and what AppSheet apps you're working on right now and how we can help you in this webinar. Again, Cameron's a professional AppSheet developer. So he's really well-versed in helping you with any questions that you have. And we love answering questions live as we're running these webinars. Sweet. All right, let's see. If you're just joining us, this is our app suite for the manufacturing industry. Looks like we still got about 7 minutes, so I want to give people plenty of time to join our stream. That way they get the full, the full content. So we'll be starting at 10 o'clock. We're going to make sure we start on time. And again, we're talking about the app suite for the manufacturing industry. We're taking a look at our equipment maintenance app, our inventory management app, safety inspection app, and I even threw in a task management app last week as well. So you're going to get four apps in this app demo today. And all of this is in the description below. So if you did want to follow along with us and build this app along with us, you can find that in the links below. And we'll go into a little bit more detail once we get started here on how to access all of these resources for you. Sweet. So don't forget to join the chat. Let us know where you're from, what you're interested in building today, what apps you're working on, and how we can help you create these features in your app. Cam, what's something cool you've been learning in AppSheet lately?
We were just talking about the multi-row actions, and yeah. I just like kind of thinking of different ways to use that. Mm-hmm. And if you guys don't know what that is, if you have a table view, if you have a multi-record view, meaning a deck view, a table view, a card view, or a gallery view, if you click and hold, it actually selects that record. And then after you have a record or many records selected, in the top right, it will show you actions that you can perform on all those records that you have selected. Yeah. And it will perform that action once per record. And it's really cool. And one thing that I worked on for a client a while ago using that was, she worked in like the art industry and had multiple galleries that she would attend a week. And so she just had a list of all the galleries, of all the art galleries that she needed to attend. And like whenever the exhibition started and when it ended and stuff. Mm-hmm. And like, it was all separated by what area of New York it was and everything. And one mm-hmm. thing we did using that multi-row action selection thing was, we made it where she could click and select like 10 galleries or whatever. Mm-hmm. And then she would hit add to do list. And then she would go to the to-do list and generate a report, and it would go to her email and send her a PDF of all the galleries that she wanted to attend that day. Nice. And so instead of like going into the detailed view of every single one of those galleries and hitting add to do and then doing that over and over and over, she was able just to select all of them in that area. And then Austin was mentioning something really cool also that I did not know about that I should tell her about, because this might be really useful. Yeah. But inside of a deck view or a table view, I believe, mm-hmm. if you have one selected mm-hmm. and then you hit shift, it actually will select all of, so like, let's say if we have selected the second item mm-hmm. and then hold shift and click the fifth item, mm-hmm. it will select all of the items 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah.
And that's super cool, because if she wanted to just select all the galleries in that neighborhood of New York, because she was able to go all them, she would be able to just shift select all those instead of having to individually click each one. So it just like optimizes something mm-hmm. that's already optimized by having yeah. that selection thing. It like further yeah. optimizes something that's already yeah. optimized. Pretty sweet.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's just speaking to like the power of just the automation and like how quick it is to execute on a new idea in AppSheet. I mean, I'd been thinking about multi-row select and bulk actions to kind of like help with data processing and stuff like that. And as I was thinking about the logic of that and how it would work, I was testing different things and trying different techniques. I finally figured out, oh, I can, use a table view. And then let me see if the shift multi-select will work. And it worked. And then I was able to add an action to a whole group of records instead of having to, like Cameron was saying, like select each record or go in and adjust it on Google Sheets and try to figure out how that data should be organized inside of my Google Sheets. And now I can just have one action that does an hour's worth of work for me in a matter of minutes. So just huge time saver.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially whenever you like, you have that idea and you're like, that's mind blowing that it's that fast.
Yeah.
But you're only thinking about it like how much faster it is than using an AppSheet app that is not optimized. But like in reality, you should be comparing to like what would that workflow be like if you were doing this on paper? It's yeah. like that would be terrible. You would have yeah. to like you would have to go to a filing cabinet and then like search for like 30 different sheets of paper.
Yeah.
Inside that filing cabinet, which alone is like a 10-minute operation of you searching through papers right. in a filing cabinet. And then you would have to go to that each of those papers, grab your pencil and check it. Each
yeah.
box.
Yeah.
Like check each box or add a note yeah. to each one. And it's yeah. just like mind-blowing how you can do all that in like half a second in AppSheet with that yeah. multi-select.
Yeah.
It's just like whenever you compare it to like the paper process that it's replacing, mm-hmm. it's like actually mind-blowing of yeah. like how much fast. And that you don't need to be a computer science yeah. master degree to be able to do this. Like yeah. somebody who just we're hiring a lot of people like that were in the education industry that have no, who had previously no knowledge of AppSheet or development, and they're already doing automations like this.
Yeah.
And so it just really speaks to the culture of the citizen developers.
Right.
And how empowered they can be.
Yeah. Awesome. Okay. So it's 10 o'clock. Let's get started on our app suite for the manufacturing industry. We're excited that everybody is here joining us. So we're going to go ahead and get into this content. All right. So like we said, if you're joining us just right now, I'm Austin from AppSheet Training. I'm the director of marketing here at Cree Technologies. So I handle all of our marketing strategy and content. So if you're interested in learning something new, you can email me at austin@creetech.com and I can see if we can get it into our content strategy. And then I'll let Cameron introduce himself.
Yeah. Hello, my name is Cameron. Cameron Lupton. I am a developer at Cree Technologies. It's about to be 4 years that I've been working at Cree Technologies and been using AppSheet since then. I previously got brought on as a graphic designer. And so a lot of what I do in AppSheet comes from a design first standpoint and just really desire to push AppSheet further. If you have scoured the AppSheet community, there's no shortage of people that complain or mention the limits of AppSheet's UI. But whenever you have an understanding of how the data changes how your app looks and how it changes the capabilities of it, then it unlocks a whole lot of things that you can do to kind of manipulate AppSheet to look the way you want it to. And so this is kind of an example of what we're going over today, of something that isn't really intuitive to like think of off the start, but like if you understand how the dichotomy of data and actions working together and what views we have available, you can do some pretty sweet views that do some pretty powerful things.
Yeah. Awesome. All right. So today we're going to be looking at the introduction of our app and some of the key features. We're going to look at common use cases. Then we'll have Cameron show you how to create this app suite and a couple of other more advanced features. And then we have a special offer for you if you stay until the end. All right. So by the end of this webinar, you're going to learn how to create an app suite with Google Cloud's AppSheet without spending hours searching through documentation or forms. So we've got it all packaged for you right here. So make sure you're paying attention and staying with us. And then if you stay until the end, like I said, we have a special offer for you. Okay, so if you want to get the most out of today's webinar, here's some things that you can do to kind of prepare yourself and to get you ready for building this app suite with us. So I'm going to go ahead and head over here. This is our, we call this our quick reference guide. This is for getting you started on the app suite. So this is found in the description below. It says quick reference guide, and it's it has a link to this document. And then you can click through. And when you come to this page, this is our app template. You'll click this link here. It navigates you to our AppSheet portfolio. It looks like this. What you're going to want to do is copy and customize. This will give you access to this app on your AppSheet profile. And then once you do that, you're able to access our app suite. And it will be automatically created for you with all the features that we've added into it. So go ahead and make sure you get that app copied over so that you can follow along with us. Also, like I said, Cameron is a professional AppSheet developer. He does consulting with clients around the world, and he does development projects with clients around the world. So if you are wanting to learn more, you have specific questions about what or how to create these features in your own app builds today, now's the time to ask Cameron, and he can help you build those features out as we're moving along in this webinar. So if you treat it like a one-on-one consulting time with one of our developers, like Cameron is here today, you're gonna get a lot of great content and a lot of great resources out of this webinar. And we wanna really make sure that it's relevant to you and what you're working on. So please feel free to throw those comments in the chat and we can answer those and make sure we're answering your questions to help you grow in your AppSheet development process. Awesome. All right. So like I said before, we are an AppSheet partner. So you can find us on their partner page right here. And if you're an organization and you're trying to move from that paper-based workflow or even just spreadsheet workflow into a more app and user-friendly workflow, AppSheet believes that training and onboarding is the best way to transition into a citizen developer culture. So that's what we provide here at AppSheet Training. So if you're interested in working with us and helping your team transition into that citizen developer culture, please feel free to reach out to me. You can sign up for a tech talk. That's in the description below. And then we can discuss the details of working with your organization. All right. And this is our trusted AppSheet experts. This is our crew. The cool thing about our company is we combine that expert teaching experience with the expert development experience, kind of giving you the best of both worlds to help you on your learning journey with AppSheet. All right, so I want you guys to imagine in your workplace, if all of your repetitive tasks were completely automated, paperwork was now an automated process, spreadsheets weren't your main user interface, but a custom built app, team members are empowered to create their own automated workflows. What would that do to your work environment? And just think about how impactful that could be to create a work environment like that. Okay, so next we're gonna look at some common use cases. So some of our common use cases that we looked at previously was our safety inspections, our inventory management, our maintenance tracking app. And then today we're gonna take a look at task management. And more specifically, we're gonna stay within that app suite. And so Cameron's going to be showing you how to build out those features. Excuse me. So what is an app suite? An app suite is a way to digitally manage a suite of apps throughout your organization. So like we've looked at, we made about 3 apps this month. And then I made 1 additional app, the task management app. And then we are combining all of those into 1 main user interface so that people can move between the apps easily throughout your organization. So let's look at some key features. So the key features of this app is it's gonna have a gallery view. There's gonna be links to multiple apps and the ability to add more apps to the app suite. So let's say your company needs a different app for a more specific task. and one of the citizen developers in your organization is like, I wanna build this app to automate this business process. And so they build it. Well, then once that build is done, you can easily add that next app into your suite of apps. All right, so let's look at the demo. So I'm gonna go over here to our AppSheet app. So this is our app launcher and our suite of apps. So we have, like I said, the equipment maintenance app, our inventory management app, safety inspection app, and our task manager. So all we have to do is click on one of the gallery icons and it takes us directly to this app. So this is our equipment maintenance app that we looked at one of our previous webinars, and then it has a cool feature that AppSheet puts in there for you that navigates you back to the launcher. And then we can look at our inventory management app. Again, all of these are in the portfolio. So you can have access to each of these individual apps, or you can have just the launcher. And so that one sends us there. And then all I'm doing is clicking on App Suite Manufacturing, and it takes us directly back to our launcher page. So that's just the basic workflow. And then if we wanted to add another app, we could do that there. All right, and this is kind of like a look at what the column structure will look like. So we have that ID column, the app name, the image, and the app link. But Cam will show you how to configure all that in just a minute. All right, so I'm gonna go back over here. So next, let's talk about creating this app suite. So I always like to talk about kind of the idea and how to get from point A to point B. So it all starts with your database. You're gonna wanna make sure you structure your data correctly. That way, when you get to the editor, it's easy for AppSheet to connect and see what you're wanting to build. And then the last part is user adoption. So you're going to deploy your app throughout your organization and make sure it's easy to use. That way, everybody's able to use the app and put it into their workflows quickly and easily. So the way we do that is we're going to prepare our data first. We're going to organize it so it meets the needs of your team or your project. And then here's the database design. So these are our three different apps that we have there. And then, like I said, we also have a task management app. So as you can see, we're kind of following a similar pattern here. Every table or every database has a team table. And then these two inspection ones have the facility or a job site. And then they're all funneling down into some kind of form. So this inventory, maintenance, and safety form. But for our purpose, our parent table is the app suite or the launcher. So there's only one table in our main app, which is connected through a column to all these other apps. And then this is the database for the inventory, for the equipment, and for the safety inspection. So that's kind of a bird's eye view of what each of these apps database look like. All right, so then next we'll move into the UX. So we're gonna create those custom views to display data in an easily accessible way. And then we'll create some custom actions to navigate users to the appropriate app. All right, so that's all I've got for now. And again, if you have questions, Cam is available to answer those questions on how to put these features into your builds. So I'm going to go ahead and stop sharing, and Cam will show you how to build out these features.
All right, guys. So let me go ahead and share my screen. All right, on my screen over here on the right side, let me go ahead and zoom in just a bit for you guys. Yeah, so today, Austin had built out an app that essentially is a mediator app, a app launcher app that will navigate us to different apps within this manufacturing industry companies, different apps they use on a daily basis. This is something that we actually tend to do with almost every single client, actually. So usually a client will come to us and have a individual use case, and we'll build an app for that. And then they kind of like fall in love with AppSheet, and they're like, hey, we also want to build an app to manage our fleet of cars, a fleet of vehicles, and like keep up with like inspections and oil changes and tire rotations and all that stuff. And then they're like, we also want to build the clock-in app because this, and it gets to a point where they have five apps on their home screen on their phone or in their app gallery, and it's just not the best way to do it. And so almost every single long-term relationship we have with clients end up with a app launcher of something like this. And so we're going to go ahead and get into building this, and Austin showed us something in the office that was really cool. And that is that whenever you are setting up the data structure, we'll just go over the data structure real quick first. So we have one table right here, and it's called Launcher. This is a table that only has four columns. It's nice and easy, has a unique ID. It has an app name. This is the name of the app or the label that we want to communicate to the user where we're sending them whenever they click on it. This right here is an image, this is the icon.
Do you mind zooming in a little bit?
Yeah, I'll go ahead and zoom in on this one also.
Thank you.
Sorry, that 5K monitor was a little intense.
No worries.
And so, yeah, right here we have images. These are the icons that we are actually physically going to click on. And then we have the app link. And so with the app link right here, you can put in just the information that follows So it's kind of small and I can't really zoom in on my URL, but inside of the URL, whenever you're in the editor or whenever you're viewing an app with an AppSheet, you'll see appsheet.com/a few things. And then you'll run into a suffix that goes app name. Everything after app name equals, you want to copy that. And then you want to stop at the ampersand. So usually what it's going to be is going to be the name of the app, and then a dash, and then the user ID of your AppSheet account. That's usually the way the AppSheet creates the app ID. And so just to reiterate that, the app address that you want to copy is going to be in the URL, and it's everything after the equal sign and before the ampersand that follows.
Nice.
Sweet. And so a lot of times in the past, with clients, we'll see them having this column as a text field, and they will use a link to app, and they will target that and use it as text. But actually, if you use this column and you set it to a data type of app, it does something really cool for you. So I'm going to go ahead and change it to text real quick and hit save. So that way we can see what it does for us. All right, so we can see right here that we have three actions that are assigned to the launcher. And if we go back into the columns now and then set this app link into app and then hit save. And then now if we go to behavior, it's auto-created this fourth system action. And what it does is it goes to the app link. And so it's just like a really easy action button that will take the user to the address that's inside this column.
Yeah.
Meaning if I click the button while I'm in this record, it'll take me to the app with that address. So now if we click right here, we're going to see that it just takes us to another view. That is because right now the action that is assigned to clicking of one of these gallery options is currently just edit. So to actually edit this view right here, we could go through here and go to UX and then find that view in the list of views. But you could also just click this little view shortcut and it'll take us straight to the editor of that view. And so what we're wanting to change, we're happy with almost everything here. The only thing that we really want to change is the behavior that happens whenever we click one of these options. So all we have to do is scroll down to behavior and we see event action. When a row is selected, it's currently editing. And so if we switch that to go to app link, select that, then hit save. Real quickly, we have an app launcher. So we are currently in this app launcher. And then whenever we click into this inventory management app, we can see that it's syncing and loading up a new app. And just like that, we're in the app that we were covering 2 weeks ago. And so this like automatically merges all these apps that you have with still taking advantage of separating the data to like keep sync speeds quick. That way it's not all one giant app. So it's super efficient. And one cool thing that AppSheet actually does for us whenever we go from one app to another is if we go into the side menu right here, we see that there's a little action button that will take us back to that launcher that we were previously on. So I can click that and really quickly, it sends me straight back to that launcher. So nice. One thing that we usually do is we'll have this primary app launcher app that only has one view and it's just the launcher. However, whenever we are inside of, let's say, task management app, we would have that same launcher gallery view, but we would have it as a menu view right here. That way you have the option to navigate back to that launcher view right here if you just want to go back to your previous app. But we would also have a launcher inside of here in the menu where you can choose from going from the task manager app to another app instead of having to go to that mediator app in between. And so what we would suggest to people is that on their home screen, on their iPhone or on their tablet or bookmarked on their browser, we would suggest them to have this one be like the only icon. That way they can click into here and then quickly navigate to whichever app they want. And so one way that we can push this further is showing and hiding different users, specific apps. And so we're actually going to go ahead and do that. Austin,
what's up, dude?
There's two different ideas that I want to, that I could cover. I want you to choose which one you want. Or maybe you want to pull the audience. We could either have admins and non-admins.
Okay.
And we could set a we could set specific apps as an admin app and specific apps as available to anybody.
Okay.
Or we could make it where specific apps are only available to specific roles. And then last is we could give permission individually to specific apps to specific users.
I like the roles idea.
Okay.
Like maybe just two different roles, like a admin and an employee, or I don't know if you want to do three roles.
Yeah, I would like an admin. Let's say admin. Let's say what are some roles that would be inside the manufacturing industry?
We'd have managers and then frontline workers.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and go into team. And then we have this team table that's not currently inside the app, and we currently have an admin. So previously before this, I was kind of intending on going the admin route, but I'll just go ahead and do this.
Cool.
So we'll say role.
Nice.
We'll say Stefan is an admin. We'll say that Austin is a manager. And then we'll say me and Clark are frontline.
Cool.
Pretty awesome with AppSheet how quickly you can pivot into just a whole entire different
workflow.
Yeah. And so what I want to do is I want to actually copy these three roles.
Yeah.
And I want to say which role these apps are available to. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to go ahead and add another column to the right, and I'm going to say, show for, and then let's say this one should be available for everybody. Let's say admin, and then we can do a comma separated list. We can say admin, manager, and frontline.
Nice.
Want to make sure I spelt them the same over here as in the other side. Okay, I believe I did. Might run into an error. I mean, not an error, but a situation where I did not spell it right. Yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that, and I'm going to change that for different apps. So let's say this app right here is available to everybody but frontline. Or let's keep that frontline. Let's make it where managers should see that. And this one, let's just make it only admin. So thank you. I don't want that auto suggested. And this one right here, let's make it for managers and admins only.
Nice.
So right here is I'm creating a list of what roles we want to have access to actually view the app. And so I'm going to say, app access instead.
Yeah, that's cool.
I feel like I don't know how to spell. Is that how you spell access?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Nice.
So, hey, I'm still learning English, guys. I saw that we have some people from Russia, some people from Peru, some people from Malaysia, some people from Slovakia. And I'm confident that every single one of you guys know English better than me. which it's awesome just to see that we have people from Russia, that we have people from Slovakia, from Malaysia, and from Peru. Mm-hmm. If you guys are from somewhere else other than those four countries, go ahead and share in the chat where you're from. It's super cool and super fun to see where everybody's from.
Yeah.
But yeah, we just added a new column. So that means we have to regenerate it. And then we also want to add this new table into the app. So let's go ahead and do that real quickly. So we'll want to go to data. Ah, Colombia.
Nice.
Niagara Falls, United States. So
awesome.
You basically have half citizenship to Canada if you live in USA Niagara Falls.
Yeah.
All right, David, which side of Niagara Falls is prettier, the U.S. side or the Canadian side? I hear debates about it all the time. I want to hear a local's opinion. So I'm going to go ahead and add this table right here.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and we got a little error because I have not yet regenerated this one right here, even though we added that column. So let's go ahead and regenerate.
David said,
Canadians. Hey, at least you're honest. That's very humble of you to say. Users only can access to their own department apps. Only back in office can have their access to all apps, but all of this is limited to your position. Yeah, that's totally possible. In that situation, I would probably do an ifs statement and say like ifs role equals ifs role equals office, then true, and it will show all of the apps. Mm-hmm. And then else, it would only show the apps where that department owner of the app department would only see access to their own department. So it'd be like user department equals this app's assigned department.
Nice.
You would really only need if.
Yeah.
For that. But yeah. All right. So we got all these columns back into our app now. We got this new table and we're no longer throwing errors. How can I remove the menu bar at the bottom? I have not really tried that, but what I would assume, if you could do it, let's go ahead and try to make this a menu item.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. So just by making, just by removing all of the views from either the leftmost, left, center, right, or rightmost options inside the position of a view, if you remove all those and just either change them to ref or menu, then you'll be left with an app with no thumb menu. It's pretty cool.
Yep.
Let me know if that answered your question fully or if you need me to re-demo that for you, Luis.
Yeah, that's a great question.
Yeah. Yeah, that would actually be really solid for this app right here because we don't need them to be switching apps.
Right.
Yeah, that is a good question. All right, so back into assigning the different roles. And so what we could do is we can make this a slice and we can make this view based off a slice and they only see the apps that are viewed, but we want to actually go into security filters instead of slices. They would essentially do the same thing, not too worried about security, but so we'll just do it from here. Both ways would be just fine, especially in this instance. Mm-hmm. All right, so for security filter, we want to use an in function. The in function will check if a value is inside of a list of values. So if I have a list that goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I'm checking if the number 2 is in that list of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it will return true because 2 is indeed found in that list. However, if I said is 7 found in that list of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it would return false because 7 is not found in that list. What we want to do is we want to use that function to see if this role of the user is found in this list. And so if it's true, it will show the app if it's false, it will exclude the app from that view. And so let's go ahead and type in the in function. And so the in function, the syntax for it is super fun. The way I like to think about it is the needle found in the haystack? So is the single item found in the haystack, the list of items? One thing to keep in mind inside the in function is that if you are searching for a needle that is, let's say, a data type of text, you will need to you need a list of text data types. You can't search for a text in a list of date times or something like that. And so let's go ahead and do that. First, we need to find out what our needle is. Our needle is, in this situation, the person who's currently logged, the person who's logged into the app. We want the needle to be that team member's role. All right, and so just let's go ahead and open up AppSheet toolbox right here. Let's go to schema and go to the team table. So we want to return the role, and we can see that the data type of the role is text. And so let's go ahead and create an expression that returns the role of the person who's currently logged into the app. So we're gonna do a any select. If you don't know how to do a select, we have plenty of videos covering the select and breaking down the syntax and how to manipulate what it's returning based off of changing different parameters with it. So with the select, we want to go ahead and type in team. And then the out of that team table, the column that we want to return is their role. We want to add a comma. And then here we're putting in the filter condition of which record out of the team table we actually want to return. And the way we do that is we want the email to equal the email of the person who is currently logged into the app. So if I'm logged in as Cameron at crewtech.com, this user email function is going to return Cameron at crewtech.com. If I'm logged into app at Resource Solutions, it will return app at Resource Solutions. So we'll return the role of Cameron at crewtech.com. And so this is basically creating the needle, defining the needle right here. This is a user email function that is nested inside of a select function, which is then nested inside of any function. That is the first parameter of an end function. Yes. So now we want to see if that needle is inside of this right here, the app access. Mm-hmm. So let's type in app access. I'm automatically thinking of an issue. Yes. Immediately, I see an issue that this is not going to work because this currently is not a list of text. It is just a text. So we're actually going to have to fix that real quickly. So I'm going to actually use AppSheet Toolbox again, and I'm going to create a snippet. That way I can come back to this and fix this in just a minute. So I'm going to go ahead and snippet, and then in AppSheet Toolbox right here, it saves it for me. Where did I add it? Okay, add it at the bottom right here. So I'll call this App Launcher Security Filter SF. I'll go ahead and save it. That way I can return to it later. So the issue was the haystack was appearing as just a text because I had not changed the data type to a list. And so now if I go into the team and if I go to the columns, I want to now, launcher, I want to give app access to a list of texts. So we want to make sure that the values are right here. And let's just say admin was the first one, manager, and then last but not least was frontline, the most important ones. once you make all the money. All right. And just to make sure that this is working as I want it to, let's go ahead and hit save and let's try that expression again. The only issue I could think of is that it's still looking at this as one long item instead of it looking at it as three items. And so we'll see if that is the case or not whenever we put this expression back in. So let's go to security filters. Let's go and apply it to the launcher. And then let's go ahead and paste it back in from our AppSheet toolbox. Man, that is so great to have.
Yeah.
All right. It says parameter 2 of the function in is the wrong type. Is an enum of what should be text. I'm going to copy that and hit save and see if AppSheet still complains after I hit save. Okay, it did.
While you're working on that, Cam, yeah. I just wanted to, Jonathan, he is asking about if it is possible to just have like a team table on the launcher app as the main team table that supports the rest of the apps.
Yeah, absolutely. Cool. You can have 30 apps connected to the same table. And so you don't need a separate team table for each app. Mm-hmm. That team table could be on a separate spreadsheet if you wanted to. It could be anywhere that you have access to. And you can have every single app in your app suite all using the same team table. Absolutely.
Nice. Great
question. And that's what Jonathan. We would actually, that's actually what we would suggest.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm just going to check that all my parentheses are in the right place. Mm-hmm. I'm going to check that this is looking at this as a list. Okay, so I guess it just wasn't looking at app access as a list. Oh, I know the issue. Enum is not a list. Enum list is a list.
Yes.
Yes. So yeah. Indeed, the column type I selected was not a list, which is still the incorrect data type. Mm-hmm. All right. So now it's enum of text, enum list of text, and I should no longer need that list function around a list. Wow. I don't know how that slipped my mind. There we go.
That's okay. This is
part of app development. Let's hit save. I haven't hit save since switching it to enum list, so it said it was still an error, but it's good as soon as it brings in both those changes at once.
Nice.
All right. Man, come on, chat. You should have pointed that out. All right. Awesome. So,
one more question, Cam.
Yeah.
They're wondering about a pop-up in AppSheet. I've heard y'all talk around the office about the input function and how it can create some kind of pop-up with AppSheet. Is that something that you would suggest trying for the pop-up, or how would they go about doing that?
It depends what you're trying to do with the pop-up. If mm-hmm. you want like a confirmation window of like, yes, I want to proceed with an action, sometimes after you hit save on a form, we like to be like, hey, you just created a car. And then have a, like, let's say they created a car
mm-hmm.
and inside of an inspection app. And mm-hmm. after they hit save, we would have a pop-up, a confirmation window that says, hey, you just created a new vehicle. Would you like to create the first inspection for this vehicle right now? Right. And the way you would do that is on an action. You would set an action, which is a link to view, and that link to view would take them to the inspection app, mm-hmm. to the inspection form. Mm-hmm. But you would do this little option right here inside behavior that needs confirmation. And the confirmation would be, let's just do it for this app right here. Let's say, are you sure you want to leave this app? And so what it's going to do is, whenever I hit one of these buttons right here, it's going to have a pop-up window that says, are you sure you want to leave this app? And it's going to say decline or cancel or something on one side. And on the other side, it's going to say, it's going to have a confirmation message confirming that you want to proceed. And the way you control that is by default, it will say, it will use this right here. Mm-hmm. But if you want to change what that confirmation button is, you can actually change the appearance and go to display name and type in proceed, let's say. Mm-hmm. So now if we go ahead and hit save. But yeah, there's also the input, which allows you to hit an action button on a column, and it will say, like, it'll bring up one of the inputs for, let's say, text. And it could be, you could have an input that when you click it, it says, like, the button could say add note. And mm-hmm. then you click it, it brings up a little long text input field as mm-hmm. a pop-up. And then you type it in, and then it saves it as a note.
Yeah.
And it edits that record. So you can do a few different types of pop-ups within here. I would love to hear a little bit more of your intentions with this pop-up and what you're trying to do. And yeah, David, I'll quickly go over how we could implement this team table into our app also. And then from there to be able to either promote or demote or remove or add users as well. Mm-hmm. So now if we go ahead and click one of these, we see, are you sure you want to leave this app? If I hit no, it cancels that action and we don't have to worry about it going to another app. If we click yes and proceed, it now takes us to the other app. And so that confirmation message can be applied to any action that you have inside the behaviors tab. And so you can get pretty creative on that. You can do some fun stuff with it.
Nice.
So let's go ahead and see if the thing that we did is working or not.
Yeah. So the different user roles.
So I'm currently logged into app@grease.solutions and app@grease.solutions is currently a admin. Mm-hmm. So he sees access to every single one of these apps. Well, let's go ahead and try a frontline worker. So I'm going to go ahead and copy my email, Cameron@crewtech.com. And little development secret, little development tip is that if you want to view an app as another user, you can paste it into this input right here on the bottom right under the emulator. Mm-hmm. You can paste the email. And then now you're viewing the app as if you're logged in as that person.
Mm-hmm. Peter, we got these icons on flaticon.com. So it's a great resource for finding icons, and they have transparent backgrounds. So highly recommend that website.
Yeah, Flat Icon's really good. And then a lot of the other icons that we use also are from IconDB. Meaning icon database. Mm-hmm. And with that, you can choose a specific hex color. So you can like type in what exact color you want it to be, and it will allow you to save that icon in any color you want. And so these are more like single colored icons in IconDB. Mm-hmm. And so you can like get a color picker extension and get the exact color of your UI. And then make all the icons that exact color, and it looks super clean as well. Yeah. And so this is a fun style right here where it's like this, like more stylized, more illustration based icon. If you want more mm-hmm. simple icons that are single colors that maybe match more perfectly with your UI, then you can check out IconDB.
Yeah.
And you can save it as PNG, as SVGs. You have tons of options on how you want to export it. So yeah, we switched over to Cameron at crewtech.com, and that user is a frontline worker. So he only has availability. So I'm Cameron. I only have availability to the two apps where frontline is one of the three roles available. So last but not least, let's go ahead and try a manager. The manager should only see three apps and should exclude this one right here. So let's go ahead and copy the manager, which is Austin Skidmore. Don't tell Austin. I am impersonating him right now while on a call with him.
Yeah.
And then I get to see the secret app that Austin gets to see that I don't get to see as a frontline worker. So yeah, guys, please don't tell Austin.
Yeah.
He'll beat me up. Yeah. So real quickly, I'll go ahead and show how we can implement a team table into this and then how we can actually change that user's role or add a new person. The one thing that is coming to mind for me right now is that there's an add button right here.
Mm-hmm.
We really don't need people adding. And there's also, whenever you like select it right here, there's also the delete button.
Mm-hmm.
And so we really don't want people adding and deleting these shortcuts to apps. And so what we can do is we can either go to those actions and hide those actions and make them not visible mm-hmm. by marking them as do not display right here. Where is that?
Under appearance? Yeah.
Yeah. So you can make it do not display and it will actually hide that plus sign. But the way I'm going to do it is I'm going to go to data, then go over here and I'm going to remove updates, adds, and deletes. And so it's going to change it to read only, meaning we don't really want people to add a new app. Whenever the developer who's creating apps wants to add a new app, he can just paste it into here.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll be just fine.
Yeah.
All right. So let's go ahead and add a new view. We'll make this a... we'll make it our team.
Yeah.
Our team. And we'll make it a team table. We'll add this into the menu and we'll make it a deck. We want to sort by last name and we want it to be ascending. And then we want to, after that, for the tiebreaker, if we have two Quartermonts in our office, so we have Landon and Stephen Quartermont. If they were, if we only sorted by last name, then them having a tiebreaker inside of their last name, like them having a tie in their last names on ordering, it would just add the person who's first inside the data, first inside of the view of the app. And so we actually want to specify what the tiebreaker is for last name, and that's their first name. All right. And inside of here, we don't want to group it, but we could group it by what role they are. So we could say group by role, and we would see that separated like that. I actually kind of like that. I'll leave that in right there.
Yeah.
But last but not least, let's go ahead and set the primary thing to the primary field as the computed name. And let's just make the secondary header their email. And let's go ahead and turn off action buttons. So now when somebody clicks into here, they are able to edit it and they're able to change this right here. But let's go ahead and instead of this being a text, let's make it a enum where they get to choose what role it is.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna go to team table, then go to the columns, and then I'm going to go to this and change it to an enum. And I'll make it a dropdown. And the three values will yet again be admin. Admin, manager, and frontline. I did a bad thing, I guess. AppSheet disapproved of me. Frontline, the money makers.
That's right.
All right. And so, one thing I also want to do is I don't want the ability for non-admins to be able to upgrade other people to admins. And so what I want to do is I want to make this, this menu view right here to only be accessible by admins. And I also want to change that icon because it being like a list icon is bothering me. So I'm just going to type in user. And I'll just select this thing right here, this icon. All right, behavior, or not behavior, show if right here under display. We're going to only show this column if the user's role, so the team member's role is equal, or no, we want to do email. We want to do the filter statement equals user email. And then we want to compare that value to if it equals admin. So if they're an admin, it'll show. If it is not admin, it will not show.
Nice. That's super helpful.
Yep. Let's go ahead and hit save. And then now we go ahead and come out of here now. If
you got
we see that Austin, Austin is currently logged in right now as a manager, not an admin. And so that view is not available inside of here for him. Mm-hmm. But if we go ahead and real quickly switch over to AppExpress.Solutions, who is an admin, hit apply, we'll see this new fancy our team view. And under our team, let's go ahead and promote Clark James. Congratulations, Clark James. You are now an admin.
All right, Clark.
Good job. yeah, you guys might not see him on the boot camps anymore. He's too admin-y for us now.
Yeah.
For us frontline. all right. So yeah, now he's an admin. And let's go ahead and go back to this view and let's go ahead and add Landon Portamont. That is an email. So I'm gonna go ahead and apparently not know how to use a keyboard. All right, so let's put his last name in the last name field, and let's put in his first name in this field. And let's say his role is a manager, to hit save. So now this is Peter, I'm David. This is how we actually create a team table. And from here, we can actually give them permission to specific apps. So now we could view this app as Landon, and he would have access to the three apps that managers have availability to.
Nice, dude. That's awesome. David said he learned a lot from that. Lots of new expressions. Yeah. That was sweet.
All right. Does anybody have any other final questions about this demo that you would like to ask while I'm having this app up, or would you guys like to move on to the rest of the stuff that Austin has for us? Which external automation tool do you recommend for AppSheet, like UiPath, Power Automate, and Zapier? We tend to use Zapier the most for webhooks. So if a client wants to connect their app to a Slack, or they want to connect their app into a Trello board, then we'll create that connection using Zapier. But also we have a few people in our office who are either certified or work on their certification for Google Cloud Partner, meaning, and what we do with that is we have some automations that are done on the Google App Script side. So some JavaScript and automations. And so that's a little bit like more intense, more code based, but you can do some really powerful things. And yeah, we also, a lot of the apps that we use that use SQL will do SQL triggers and have some sort of automation that runs based off the SQL triggers, which is also really cool for automation. One other question that was asked earlier was if you could put an iframe inside of a view. About 2 years ago, they were talking about them developing an iframe tool, and I think they were beta accessing it to a specific users. to a specific user. This is David who asked this question actually. Okay. You wanted to show your Etsy orders within your AppSheet app. You can't currently iframe a web page into your app. And also an issue with the iframe would be each time you go to that iframe, you would have to log in, like re-log into your Etsy account each time, because it's not caching the token of you being the like user token of you being logged in. Mm-hmm. But what you could do, David, is inside of the app launcher or an action button inside of your app, you could have a behavior that is a go to website, and you could have the URL of the website right here, and it would actually take you straight from the app into that dashboard if you have the URL for that. And so if you wanted it to be inside a launcher like this, you could add another column that is like, add another column inside of launcher that is like, this is an app or this is an external link. And then you would group the app, the link to app, and you would group the link to external website in a grouped action. And you would run the group action on that button click instead. And if it was an app that it's trying to navigate you to, it would run that first action, which is a link to app. But if the new column that we entered in was external website, it would run the second action in that grouped action that is go to external website. It would open up your browser of your phone, of your computer, into that website that you specify. But yes, nice. There's currently no way to iframe into an app right now. Which that is one thing that we've talked about in office that we would love to see.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice. Austin, would you like to take us away?
Yeah. That was great, Cam. Again, if you like this content, you want to show Cam some kudos, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. And then also, if you want to subscribe, we do these webinars weekly. So if you want to join us every week, we'll be on here weekly. We'll have Cam 1 week, and then we'll have Clark the next week. So these are expert AppSheet developers, and they love sharing their expertise with you and just getting to show you the possibilities of what you can do with AppSheet. And like Cam was explaining at the end, we'll also guide you in the right way if you have like, is this possible in AppSheet or is it not? And then we're always looking to create that solution that you're looking for. And so like Cam was demonstrating, he's trying to show you guys how you can create that view for the the iframe, and make sure that feature that you're wanting, we can try to find a solution for that. So that was awesome, Cam. Thanks for
and for the people for sure. The people that might not understand what we're talking about right now, an iframe is an HTML element that allows you to view a web page in another web page. Yeah. And so what he's asking is, can I view a specific web page inside of my app? And so it would essentially have a window inside the app. What we're wanting is a window inside of an app where you can kind of view in almost like a portal into another website.
Nice. All right. So let's review a little bit. So Cam took us through how to organize our database for our launcher and add more features onto it. And then he also talked about having one main team table that kind of helps organize all of your other apps teams as well. That way there's, like someone mentioned in the comments, that way the usability for the other apps isn't getting confusing as somebody's trying to access the app from the app launcher and they're going from different team tables. So if you have that one main team table, that's a great way to organize all of that. And then we looked at customizing those features. So Cam showed you how to set up those security filters based on user role using the in function. And then finally, it's kind of your homework, you optimize it for your business process. So we gave you access to this app in the description below. So if you want to copy it and use it for your business, we'd love to see how you're doing that and how you're using it for your business process. So if you want to take screenshots of it and tag us on social media, that's a great way to connect with us. We're on LinkedIn, Facebook, and obviously YouTube and Instagram as well. And so that's a great way to connect with us. And we love seeing community posts about the AppSheet apps y'all are making. All right. So next I want to talk about how you can connect with us even more through our website. So we have our AppSheetTraining.com website. So if you go over there, you can set up your profile. It's free to set up and you get access to our expressions page, AppSheet IQ. We're posting weekly blogs and articles on there. And you also get access to early access to like these quick reference guides and apps that we're building each week for these webinars. So highly recommend going over there to sign up for your profile. And then you can schedule a tech talk to meet with us and we can help you customize your app, set up a use case guide, figure out what functional requirements you need and get you on the right path to learning how to build out your AppSheet app from idea to deployment. And then step three, you'll start learning AppSheet and what all it can do and quickly create apps after going through some of our content. All right, so when you sign up for your profile, you're gonna get access to this AppSheet development process. It'll be sent directly to your inbox. And this is a free process that we use to kind of help us stay on the right path for creating our apps from, like I said, that idea to deployment. And then Cam was kind of demoing this earlier. This is our Chrome extension, AppSheet Toolbox. So this is also a free tool that you get when you have your AppSheet training profile. You get to use it to access like your data and some snippets of expressions and everything. So it's a great tool. We use it in all of our app builds, helps navigating between the different tables really easily. I've seen some people having to write down the data tables on a piece of paper and then maybe even going back and forth between windows, but this toolbox keeps it all in one space. So you'd never have to leave the editor when you're using the AppSheet toolbox. So I highly recommend getting this for your Chrome profile as well. another great feature that we have when you sign up for your AppSheet training profile is you're gonna get access to a free build path. So Justin is the instructor for the Task Tracker app. There is an example in this app build that we did today of like a simple task management system. But Justin teaches you how to build a full task tracker app from start to finish in this free build path right here. So highly recommend this build path as well. And lastly, don't forget to sign up for your tech talk. We love meeting with citizen developers and people that are interested in learning more about AppSheet. So you can schedule your free online appointment. I have availability currently. So if you want to head over, the link is in the description. You just click on Tech Talk and it'll send you to my Calendly account. And then you can book a time to meet with us and we can help you customize your app, get expert advice and next steps on how to get your app out there and used by other users or throughout your organization. So see what times are available and let's get connected. All right, so next step, I just wanted to ask you guys a question if we could continue this conversation and see what else we have to offer. Would you be interested in learning more? And just go ahead and throw it in the chat. And if the answer is yes, I'd love to talk to you about how you can learn even more with AppSheetTraining.com. So I'll give you guys a few seconds. Awesome. Alexander says yes. Sweet. All right. Awesome. Sweet. So let's learn a little bit more about what's possible with AppSheet. Got another yes. All right. Okay. So if you're moving further along in your AppSheet learning journey and you're ready to take that next step, we highly recommend our vehicle inspection course. So you might see this first number. Whoa, that's a lot of money. This is the value that we believe that this course is worth. So we believe that our vehicle inspection build path is worth $997. It's packed with information, with expert level knowledge. And so all that included, the value of this course is about $997. And what you're gonna get inside of this course when you purchase it is you're also going to get the advanced app template of building a vehicle inspection app. And so you get the full build. It's super quick and easy to customize. Just like you saw today, you can just copy and customize it for your business process. And it's going to have all of the bells and whistles that you want for a vehicle inspection application. And it's ready to build or to use throughout your organization right when you get it. And we value this at $749 for this custom vehicle inspection app template. With that is also included the vehicle inspection database. And so you don't have to worry about how do I create a database for a vehicle inspection. This database is already designed for you. So one of our developers was already able to design the full database for you with all the columns structured correctly. Records are included. So when you are opening the app in the AppSheet editor, everything is presented well, and you know exactly how the app is supposed to function. And we value this database design at $149. So you're getting a ton of value here. On-demand participants are saying that the demos suit their style of learning. It's specific, referenceable, and efficient, and they're ready for more content. And we are working on some more content like this. Ryan Holcomb, he is an engineer that had no background in coding. And he was able to work with our team and build an AppSheet app to help automate his business process. So these things are possible for citizen developers and people that don't come from the coding background or from the software development background. I was a teacher. I'm building all these template apps. Cam, like he said, he was a graphic designer and learned how to develop on AppSheet. And he's led our Expression Mastery course countless times. He taught me everything I know about expressions. So this content is great. And people are really learning a lot. And kind of what you can think about is like life with AppSheet training and life without AppSheet training. Without AppSheet training, you're having to look through forums and lots of other AppSheet documentation. With AppSheet training, we're guiding you along the way. We're helping you build out these business applications with you. And you're just getting a great learning experience, and you're going to grow in learning what the full potential of AppSheet is rather than trying to piece together learning it on your own. And so what you get with our on-demand course is you're getting that vehicle inspection training. So learning how to build on AppSheet. And we teach you through the vehicle inspection build. It doesn't necessarily mean that you have to want to build a vehicle inspection app. This course is covering, like I said at the beginning, it's for beginners and people that are kind of new to the platform. You've maybe watched a few videos on YouTube and gone through some AppSheet training, but then you're ready to take that next step. And dive a little bit deeper in AppSheet. And so we would recommend this course. And this is an advanced app. So you're getting access to that, $749, and that Google Sheets data set. So that's your database that shows you how to structure data properly to connect with AppSheet. And Justin does a great job of showing you how to structure your data set. And so this is not only applicable to the vehicle inspection build, but also to other builds that you may want to do and just how to structure that data. So we value this at $1,895. And so then these are some questions to ask yourself. If all this app or this training did was help you create your first app, would it be worth it? And then if it automated one of your business processes, would it be worth it? Or empower you to create innovative solutions for your workflows, would it be worth it? And so I'll let you guys answer those on your own. And is wrapping up our vehicle inspection build path. We want you to unlock the full power of AppSheet. So like I said, we have all of this included in this training. You're going to get the vehicle inspection training, learn how to build that vehicle inspection app. You get the advanced app and the Google Sheets data and our actual price, what you pay. So we can help you and your organization grow with AppSheet is going to be $79. So after you sign up for your AppSheet training profile and you're ready to make that next step, the cool thing about this app is it's combining, you know, those multiple tables and teaching you how to build those data relationships create those advanced features inside of AppSheet. So I have time for a few questions. If anybody had questions about this course, what specific content is in there, about the database, maybe about expressions, the UX, maybe how is it applicable to my use case. I'd love to answer some of your questions and hear feedback about what you guys are thinking about the vehicle inspection build. And then also I have my links here. So if you have specific questions, you can email me at austin@crewtech.com. Or if you want to sign up for a free tech talk, we can look at your specific AppSheet application and kind of help you build that out with a use case guide and get you started on the right learning path. So those are the two links that you can use to kind of get in contact with me and get connected. So if anybody has any questions, just feel free to throw them in the chat. We got about 13 minutes left to stay here on this call. And then I've got some of my own questions here. If there's no more questions. Okay, let's see. Alexander says, how can the current user for security? Let's see. Cam, I think that one might be for you.
Yeah, I assume you are saying something along the lines of how can I set the security based off the current user? And we kind of covered that a little bit. We covered that in the
demo.
The demo where you would be using the function that is user email. And what that user email returns is the email of the person who's currently logged in. Okay, yeah, so the current user is, it would just return the email. The user email returns the email of the user who's logged in. And so to use that and to actually return a record, like a team record or a user record for an individual of the person who's logged in, you're gonna want to set the key of that table to be the email. And then you can select that email. You can select that record by matching that email if it equals the user email function's value. Mm-hmm. And then if you like, just go back in this video and watch how I use the AnySelect function. Mm-hmm. It'll give you a little bit more clarity on how you can use that and return different values from a specific record inside of a user table or team table.
Sure. Nice. Perfect. Yeah. That's awesome. Sweet. And yeah, like David just mentioned in the chat, if you have more specific questions and you're wanting to continue learning more, tech talks are a great way to connect with us. And we can answer those specific questions for you. So like I said, if you're wondering, is this possible with AppSheet or what training courses do y'all offer to help me dive a little bit deeper, or even our consulting? If you have an app that you're wanting to deploy for your organization quickly, consulting is a great option for that. And if you're wondering about how to get set up with one of our AppSheet developers, joining that tech talk is the way to get connected with one of our AppSheet developers. So if you are wanting consulting on your app and how to move it forward and get to the next stage so that you can start using that app throughout your organization, or maybe you're developing apps for clients and they need the app done by a certain deadline and you're struggling with a few advanced features, that's a great time to sign up for a tech talk and we'll get you situated with one of our AppSheet developers. Just like Cam was showing you guys today, he's very well versed on how to answer these questions and get you to the next step of that app development process. So he's got tons of experience there. Sweet, great questions. All right. So, so for this first question, we have, will I be able to build my own app after taking these courses? And absolutely, that's what these courses were designed for. Especially this course, since it is a build path course, you'll be able to take this app and kind of use the data structure there to kind of construct your own customized app. So you may find that some features you don't need or some other features you do need and kind of piece those together. and create your own customized app to run your business process. Again, AppSheet uses similar logic and has kind of structured way around how to create the app. And so once you start understanding that logic more and how the editor works, you can pretty much create any kind of app you want because you just know the basic structure and the format of how the AppSheet editor works and how to connect the data to AppSheet. Awesome. Do we have any more questions about the training content or even building your own apps on AppSheet? I have about 8 minutes left. And I want to make sure I'm answering all the questions and giving you guys the answers that you need. So if you still have questions, feel free to put them in the chat. Awesome. All right. All right. And then kind of wrapping up, this last question is just, who can I contact for more information? Like I said earlier, you can always reach out to myself at austin@crewtech.com. I'm happy to respond and see how we can help you and get you connected with our team here. And then also my Calendly link is in the description and it's under the Tech Talk. And when you sign up for a Tech Talk, that's how you can open up the Calendly link and get connected with me. And then we can connect you with your use case guide and either one of our AppSheet developers or some training content to help you move your project along in the right direction.
Alexander, I believe you're talking about the AppSheet toolbox extension that we've made. We keep up to date, yes. And we have a AppSheet community forum thread going on, and we'll post updates if we include a new feature or something like that. And if anybody ever runs across a bug, it pretty quickly gets pointed out inside of that community thread. And Stefan, who is our boss, the CEO, he is pretty quick to get a fix out for that and to get that running. But yes, I would say the extension is just about always up to date and very quickly up to date if it ever is out of date.
Yeah, great question. Sweet. All right, everyone. Well, had lots of great content here. Cam did a great job of showcasing what's possible with AppSheet and with the app launcher. And so again, if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And then hit the subscribe button. And then don't forget to ring the bell for notifications. Helps our channel grow, helps us find more people that are in this no-code space that love learning about different technologies like AppSheet that can help them automate their business process. One of the things that we love here at Crew Technologies is the concept of love your work. And we believe that AppSheet is one of those platforms that helps organizations all across the world to enjoy their work and love their work more, just because they're able to automate kind of the repetitive tasks that you typically don't want to be doing every day. And so you can spend more time doing the things that you love, whether that's, you know, connecting with other people, spending time with family. I have a wife and two kids, and I love getting to spend time with them and hang out with them. And so being able to automate business processes and do those repetitive tasks more quickly allows me to free up some of my time so I can spend time doing the things that I enjoy doing. And I love spending time with my family. All right. So if nobody has any more questions, we'll go ahead and wrap up this webinar. Again, I just want to thank you from the team here at AppSheet Training and Crew Technologies. Thank you for attending the webinar. It's great to interact with everybody and to connect with everybody. I hope you all have a great rest of your week. And if you sign up for a Tech Talk, I'll see you there. All right.